In the year 1938, and they remained under control of the Third Reich until the end of the Second World War. Yeah, but we talk now about after the war. So it's basically similar like to Germany. Styria, where a British zone, Burgenland, Lower Austria, and the Mühlviertel, it was an area of, or still is an area of Upper Austria. It was the Soviet zone, and governors were for the British zone. Socialist, by the way, and he had ties to Joseph Stalin. And from 1951 until 1955, president was Theodor Körner, and he belonged to the Social Kanzler. basically exploited Austria. They took control of Austria's oil fields. Some of you will probably say now that Austria is a country not particularly known for having lots of oil, but they had it. Many people in the areas controlled by the Western powers, Great Britain, France, and USA, they were malnourished, hungry, and you know what I mean. They didn't have enough food. Strikes and riots broke out in the territories controlled by the Western powers. Second World War, but still visited by many. It's a classical city, or they still have lots of traditional European architecture. I've never been to Vienna, but I definitely want to go there when times improve. Everything I have to tell you regarding the post history of Austria after World War II. It's basically like history of post World War II Germany. In Austria's case, it was just that they officially given independence in 1955, and